Hey, my name is Jesus Castello for RubyGuides.com, and in this video I want to talk about tables. How do you print, how do you display a nice, nicely formatted table on the terminal? I'm not talking about HTML tables, I'm talking about actual print display tables on the screen, and you will see what I mean in a moment. You have like a list of products, and every product has a price, and you want to print a table that shows the product and in one column and the price in another column. Well, I like the gem called terminal table, and the gem we format the table for you, so you don't have to do that manually, because it's a little harder than it looks, because you have to calculate the column width, the column size. So the longest word in the column doesn't go over your column size. So let me just show you what this looks like. And this is what I mean. So you see, coconut is the longest one, and I can make it longer. Can make it longer, and you can see it grows automatically. The table size, the width of the table keeps growing, and there's some calculations going on to find the longest and then get the table width. All of that is done for you by this gem. Another thing the gem does for you, it gets you these separators, these columns, things. You can change that. It also gives you these headings. So you can have headers, which I have defined here for name and price. So every column, and these are optional, you can remove those. Every column can have its own thing. So you can know, oh, this is the name, this is the price. You can change this and say this the product. So that's how you print a nice table. And the gem has other options for styling the table. I believe you can completely remove the lines if you want. You can change what these lines look like. For example, instead of the dash, it changes this part, as you can see. And there are other options. For that, you will have to go to the documentation of the gem, and you will find all of the style options you can change. And another gem that I like is called Table Print. So the gem is similar. So if you look at the output, it also gives you the columns, gives you the headers, and here the headers are auto-generated from the method names. So this name, if I change this, you can see that change. So the difference is that this uses objects. So this one, we just have an array. This is the array and other arrays inside it. So these super arrays are the actual rows of the column. But in this other case, notice what we have are, we have objects. Can be any object. In this case, I have product objects. And what we have is an array of these objects. So product new, coconut, product new, bacon. And the data is the same, as you can see. The only thing that changes is that now we have objects instead of arrays. And also to print this, we use this TP method, which stands for table print. So we do table print products and we get that output. And another good thing about this gem is that you can use this in Rails. You can use this not for the user, but for yourself when you're using something like Rails console. If you include table print in your gem file, then you can do TP some of your queries. So when you do something like product.all, then this will print a table of your products. And just one thing, don't do this if you have like thousands of products, because it's going to be very slow. You want to do this only for when you have like 50 or 20 products, something like that. So you probably want to filter your results with aware, something like that. So yeah, that's table print and terminal table gems to help you display nice tables that are easier to read. Hope you found this video useful. If you did, please subscribe to this channel now so you can receive more videos like this, and you will also be helping me grow this channel. So thanks a lot for watching. See you in another video.